Now, you were once PNP chief, and in that raid, so the raiding team, they were heavily armed. There were members of the Special Action Force, meron pang miyembro ng CIDG from Region 10, and they went to several properties of Pastor Apollo Quiboloy. So the raiding teams, I think, split, no? They stormed different areas. Based on your own experience, was that the right way to actually serve a warrant, sir?
It's not the right way.
Ano dapat, Senator, because ang nangyari?
If you want to serve a warrant of arrest, klaruhin mo kung saan yung saan siya nandoon. Hindi naman kailangan nga can Pastor Apollo Quiboloy be at four different locations at the same time. He is not omnipresent in all those locations. So siguruhin mo yung information mo kung nasaan siya, then doon ka mag-serve ng warrant. Hindi yung apat na location mapuntahan mo. Para ka lang nagsisearch ng apat na location wherein they were not armed with a search warrant for that purpose. So yun lang. Ako ka rin. Since mayroong warrant si Pastor Apollo Quiboloy, wala akong problema, gawin yung trabaho niyo. Basta do it in a manner na hindi kayo hindi niyo maabuso yung rights ng ibang tao, and do it properly. Yun lang naman ang gusto ma-establish ng investigation natin.
No, do you know where he is? Nasa na ba si Quiboloy, sir?
Hindi ko alam, Karen. Hindi ko alam. Wala pang warrant of arrest na lumabas doon. Eh. Hindi naman natin nakikita na. Hindi naman natin na nakakausap.
Okay. All right. I think to close, though, we don't have enough time, but I wanted to ask you. You attended, actually, the budget hearing that was chaired by Senator Grace Poe of the Finance Committee. And there was a heated exchange between Senator Risa Ontiveros and Vice President Sara Duterte. Wala pa kayo nun, sir, no? Nung nagsagutan po sila.
Late ako dumating kasi may hearing ako doon sa kay Pastor Apollo Quiboloy na pag-serve ng warrant. Nasa kabilang kuwan ako, kabilang room ako nag-hearing. So late na ako dumating.
All right. So my last question is this. There's a controversy because the OVP is asking for 10 million pesos as an allocation for a book that has been authored by Vice President Sara Duterte. And the book is called Isang Kaibigan. So she wants 10 million pesos to distribute a book that she has authored. This is not about the content of the book, but should the Filipino people spend money for her book? What do you think?
And if it is approved, yung kanyang yung gastos na yan, kung yan ay nakalagay sa GAA, at let the Commission on Audit question kung anong technicalities ng violation, kung mayroon mga violation na ginawa yung Office of the Vice President. So, titingnan natin sa kuha. May kuha naman tayo na nag-audit sa lahat ng expenses.
Kasi Senate President Chis Escudero said that the Senate will vote. The Senate will vote if the OVP can keep the 10 million pesos para doon sa libro niya. If not, it will be realigned. So ang tanong ko, boboto ba kayo for the Vice President to keep her 10 million for her book?
Hindi ko pa napag-aralan, Karen. Hindi ko na alam yung nitty-gritty of that book. Narinig ko lang. Pag-aralan ko muna bago ako boboto kung when it comes to voting.
Okay. All right. Anything else you'd like to add, Senator, before we go?
Okay na po, Karen. Maraming salamat. Maraming salamat sa inyo.
All right. Okay.
Opportunity.
All right. As always, thank you so much. I do hope you get a better internet provider next time. Thank you. Thank you. Senator Bacon.
Salamat, Karen. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you for joining me. Thank you.